In this video, we just look at an introduction of what area is. Area will be the amount of space inside the boundary of a flat or two-dimensional object measured in square units. It's not enough just to say the area is the inside and the perimeter is the outside. That's kind of a standard student answer. We want more than that. The perimeter, as I defined in the previous lesson, is the measure or the length around a figure. Okay, it's not just the outside. And the area is not just the inside. It's the amount of space inside a two-dimensional object, and we measure it in squares. So in this diagram here, you can see that reminds me of the Chevrolet symbol a little bit, but there's little squares embedded into it. It's made up of squares. If you were just to count those, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all the way, I believe there's 20. And so we would say that this figure as a total has an area of 20 square units. It's made up, the area or space inside is made up of those. Sometimes we can abbreviate that, or many times we abbreviate that with whatever the units are, and we'll put a little square symbol there. Do not fall trap to calling that 20 units square. No, it's 20 square units. All right. There are lots of shapes, though, that it's not so obvious to draw squares inside those. On my last video, we examined the perimeter of these two figures. But if you think about drawing squares, inside them, it's not going to be so easy. For example, the one on the left, it talks about miles, and that's 6 miles, and this base is 3 miles right here. So if I were to cut up into 1 mile chunks, I might imagine that a 1 mile square might look something like this. I'm just using my imagination. There's one square, but I'm quickly going to run into trouble when I try to make grid lines here, right? I'm going to have partial and half squares and so on. So we're going to talk about that in a future lesson. Also, the one on the right, you can see that squares don't nicely fit in there. And not only that, if we're talking about inches, then a square inch would be pretty small. It would be a little chunk here where it's 1 inch by 1 inch. And so it would be those kinds of squares that we're trying to fit in there and figure out how many square inches. You'll see this playing out in the future lessons. So stay tuned.